fixed an issue in the on ball steal system that forced the ball to yo-yo back to the previous hand midway through a crossover or behind the back move. So maybe this is going to be the key to fixing this thing. Maybe it was the yo-yoing that was causing some of the steals that people felt like they shouldn't be getting. If they still are crying about steals after this, maybe they're still broken, or maybe people just need shut the
wrong when I pencil in. Phone steady jumping, screening calls like I'm pimping bricks. Got everybody tapping in, but you've been kept it solid. When you look me in the eyes, subtle tell, I know you got it. When you do the sauce, make me want it a la carte. Caught me looking at it like the bullseye of the target.
Good afternoon out there, 2K land, man. Check this out. Full disclosure, as always, man, y'all boys going absolutely ham on the video already. 8.1 thousand views, 15.2% click rate. That means that 15.2% of the people that see the video, they're clicking on it. So if my 100,000 subs all get the video, then we'll get like 15,000 views, man. With look at that, 500 likes already. Yeah, hey, this is the stuff of legend. And because of that, all of y'all are legends as well. We got to put y'all up here on the Noti Gang Wall of Fame. Anybody come through and hit those buttons? Hey, Noti Gang, all that, man. Age, man, he says, I catch you every morning while dropping my girls off at school. Then in the back seat. Good morning out there in 2K land, man. I appreciate that, man. The top comment from today also is we got one of my guys, man. He says, hey, Brute Squad, I'm glad that I ran him through you. Consistency is the key to success. Hey, but what's up with the players feeling slow depending on the game? Not because of the defenders. I usually play with randoms and I shoot about 65% from the three, but sometimes I'm slow and my jump shot is slow and very inconsistent. I don't know why that happens. It just happens. But they talking about that. They said they fixed that in the patch notes today that we're about to go over. Also, he says, hey, man, a man can only go so far by himself, but together they can go further. Keep it 100, Jay. Keep it like my brother. You got to do that, man. Team light skin for the win, man. Hey, last but not least, he said, question if Mike can put a barrier on people closing out, why can't they put a delay or a cooldown on the reaching and spamming? I took it a step further and said you should just lose 70% of effectiveness after your first reach on the possession. So you just can't keep spamming. If you keep spamming, you should just fall out of bounds and just go out of there and just get up out of there, man. That's how I see how it should work, man. And with all that out of the way, land, look, if you know the intro, say it with your boy. Yes, sir! What's going on, everybody? It's your boy, J-Eazy, a.k.a. Fresh from the Barbershop, BK of the People's Champ, coming to you live with another video, man. I'm trying to get through this because I know this is going to be a long video, but we have all of the patch notes. We're going to try to go through all of the relevant patch notes right here. But let's do me a favor. Like I said, somebody's going to get this Eat Sleep 2K repeat. You just got to comment on last video, comment on this video, like the videos. Let's try to get to 300 likes before we get to 1,500 views so we can get that 15% click rate and go to the moon. Now, listen, if nobody told you this today, y'all my brothers, my sisters, my family. I love each and every last one of y'all, man. We just going to get right into it. I'm going to read this as fast as we can. We just going to try to go over the relevant stuff. Gameplay. Look, dunk meter dunks will now display we now use the proper standing dunk rating instead of the driving dunk rating to determine the green window size on the standing dunks, because the standing dunk meter was using the driving dunk, but now we got that fixed. Dunk meter logic has been updated to make the window size better reflect dunk difficulty. So if you're punching on somebody with 25 interior, you will see a significant difference, whether if you're dunking on somebody like me with 70, 80 interior. So it's going to be a dynamic window again instead of that little bitty fixed, you know, piece of window. So that's cool. Hey, fixed an issue in the on-ball steal system that forced the ball to yo-yo back to the previous hand midway through a crossover or behind the back move. So maybe this is going to be the key to fixing this thing. Maybe it was the yo-yoing that was causing some of the steals that people felt like they shouldn't be getting. If they still are crying about steals after this, maybe they're still broken, or maybe people just need shut the fuck up. Shut the fuck up, because I done read through this stuff, man, and this stuff is so offensively heavy, I don't know how we gonna stop nobody tomorrow, man. I ain't gonna lie to y'all. I really don't care, man. I play the game for fun. I do it for y'all. We about to do sub wars this evening. If y'all want to do sub wars, make sure y'all go to the Discord. The link is in the description. I'm just gonna put that. We're gonna go down to the beach and we just gonna play against each other, man. I'm putting subs against subs and we just gonna see how that goes, man. Hey, so we just having fun with the game from here on out. Hey, says also says improve foot planting to reduce unwanted out of bounds violations when shooting near the sidelines. Okay, I can rock with that. We can still push people out, but we can force them out, but they're not gonna go out by themselves. When blockers jump early and land on ball handlers or shooters, foul will be called 100% of the time. I don't know how I like about that, big dog, but we're gonna see. If you jump early or whatever and you go up into them, it's not gonna be any more of that pump faking pump. Like, you know, if you go up, you're just gonna get caught. That seems that it's slanted in the way of the offense, but hey, it is what it is. Better shot coverage detection for open versus wide open. Man, I'm just worried about the ones where they jumped at me from a mile away and then they hit me and nothing was happening. So I guess that works. Slight buff to the close shots, wide open jump shots, and limitless range bands. I don't know how I feel about that, man. It was all, it's hard to stop people now. But if they stretch the court to where they can shoot from even further, I don't know, man. This is really going in favor of the offense, man. Say goodbye to defense, I guess. Hey, fixed an exploit that allowed players to double dribble by alley-oop faking, passing to no one in the 1v1 games. That sucked. You know, they could do it in any game. It wasn't just that, but hey, I digress. Hey, removed a pass interception on the right stick up as it was being abused for easy steals with no risk. Let me tell y'all something. I was wondering how people were stealing the ball so much and nobody was saying anything, and people was just standing in the lane holding L2. This is what the comp guys was doing, making y'all think they were better than y'all, but when they really was just doing some bullshit that y'all wasn't aware of. So they were standing in the lane holding L2, and then they were just holding the right stick up when they, you know, you could just hold it up, and when they threw the pass, that's when they were getting the interception. There wasn't any skill component to it. They were just standing in the lane just like the old one, and it made it act like the old interceptor. As long as you were in the lane, they were getting that joint, man. So they took that out because it was being abused. Updated adrenaline system to account for successfully stopping post moves and no longer consume boost when driving directly toward the rim. So successfully stopping a post move. Okay, well, that's cool, man. If you stop a post move and it takes an adrenaline from them, so hey, it's cool with that. I guess that's what it is, man. So we got defense in the game. You know, we pushing it back. It's the pendulum swinging back and forth. Fixed a minor aesthetic issue with Klay Thompson's jump shot. Didn't even know that was in there. Addressed a rare issue in which the ball can get stuck on the stanchion. I guess. Hey, change the heat check and recharge player indicator icons to only display when relevant. So that's cool, because we used to see people with the joint all game and they wasn't even activated. So I guess that's what it is. Limit the distance from which rebounds and branch to putbacks. Bro, no. Okay, so if you go for the putback, you're good. They're talking about if you go for the rebound, grab the rebound, and then you change it to a putback. Because some people were kind of abusing that, so it is what it is. I wonder if they fixed them 30-foot layups that Laker fan was talking about, but hey, it is what it is. Hey, fixed an issue that was causing putbacks and mid-air layups to be classified as covered when no defenders were nearby. So yeah, that didn't happen that much, but I definitely caught them joints off the rim. Improved the responsiveness of stopping when setting a screen. All right. You know, bad picks. I liked it because it was a risk to set those bad picks, but hey, you know, let's help the offense out a little bit more. Updated griefing logic to differentiate versus good and bad full court shots. Is there ever a good full court shot unless it's at the end of the shot clock? And also account for players with high grades or what have you. That's cool. Hey, fix excessive violations committed even when firing off multiple times incorrectly. Good defensive possession, incorrectly firing on free throws. Lazy defense now includes camping out of bounds, and improved bad timeout logic for teammate grade. I guess, man, addressed a rare issue preventing players from being able to break out of certain pass animations. So, hey, that's where we at with that, man. Hey, we're going to go to general. Hey, prepare for the season 2. We know that numerous enhancements to the UI, continued updates and adjustments that have improved the face. We don't care about face scans. Fixed a user reported issue that prevented certain previously equipped layups and dunk animations from being assigned to the player. That's cool. Revolves resolved the hang that occurred in the tattoo editing. Okay, commentary and music, we don't care about that. Change the unit of measurement, we don't care about that. The sponsor, the spacing the logo. All right, we ain't gonna worry about that, man. We gonna go down here to the city and park, and then we gonna get up out of here, man. He said, made many improvements to the performance, stability, and visuals that have been made to enhance the overall experience in the city. Made changes to reduce user reported latency. This should have been the first thing that we saw, but it's cool. Latency during multiplayer in the city and everywhere else, not just the city. So that's dope. Hey, squads are now able to chat when waiting on the got next circles. That's dope. Progression earned in the pro-am and starting five games will now be retained if the opponent leaves. So that's good, man, because I was making people quit and I'm having to take it easy on them. Then they come back and then they beat me, and then, you know, why people quitting? It ain't no record in there, so it don't matter. So now we can make people quit and we get that dub, man. Visuals on the elite courts menu have been improved so that all courts are more easily readable. Custom shoes will now be now appear in the rec clothing. So yeah, you can now wear your custom shoes in the rec. So that's dope. Stats will now properly appear on the team matchup overlay when playing pro-am games. That's dope. To get on and off animations, get off animations for various vehicles have been sped up. That's cool. Okay, cool. Fixed a rare issue that could cause loading icon to appear indefinitely when in the city. Okay, so that's what people was asking me. They was like, yo, why this joint loading the whole time? I was like, I don't know, I didn't even really notice it. Resolved a rare timing issue that could cause players to show up as invisible after accepting an invite. That's cool. Players appearing on the social menu can now be directly joined when in an available state. So it doesn't matter who it is, you can look at them and you can just join them. So that's cool. The social menu can now be used when waiting on the got next spot. That's dope, because we couldn't see nothing when we on the got next spot. Social notifications will no longer appear when playing in games in the city. So you're not gonna get the you know, you won't see it when somebody invites you when you're in the game. Hey, look one and look two now switching between as expected. Okay, that's fine. Resolved an issue that could cause default clothing items to override equipments. That's cool. A fixed a rare issue with the tattoo part of preventing clothing from being removed, hindering the placement. Okay, that's cool. The heat check and the recharge reward boost will now properly apply in non-NBA games. So we didn't even have the heat check or any of that. And the heat check is after three shots, and after all of that, and the recharge is after one, I guess. So that's gonna be cool. Affiliation specific rewards are now properly removed from a player's inventory when transferring. No! So if you moved and you bought the elite pet, T, they stealing your elite pants. You gonna be out there butt ass naked now. Oh, why? Cause so a lot of people went to the affiliation, bought the helmet, and then they switched to elite, or they got the elite pants and switched back to Rise. And I don't know who complained about that, but hey, it is what it is. Players will now be removed from the starting five games when idling for too long. That's cool. The win streak count will now appear correctly during the post-game recap sequence after the games in the city. That's dope. The player matchup screen in rec games will now correctly show the four best attributes for the player. Okay, that's dope. Let's see. The difficulty on the initial street ball opponents has been lowered. I mean, I was cool. I was busting their ass anyway, so it didn't matter. I'm out there sweating like Chicago beef for real. Resolved to hang where quitting a street ball game during an action replay, and then address the functionality issue that could occur with the street ball player select menu after losing a rematch game. And so, like, mostly the stuff, man, my career and all that stuff, multiple fixes and adjustments, like this is the main stuff that we're talking about, fixing, tracking, and all that. All of this rest of the stuff, this is a massive patch, right? This is a massive patch. I don't know if they did really anything with the GOAT or whatever, but I'm not looking at my team. And the only thing I'm looking at is the city. Voila, huh? That's all I'm looking at. The video already long enough, but this is what's gonna be in the patch. I'm assuming that it's gonna be in the morning because it says new gen patch, October 10th. This is patch 1.4. It's coming out. If you want the link to it, I'm gonna leave the link to the Discord down in the description. And actually, I will leave all the patch notes. What I'm gonna do, I'm gonna go right here and I'm gonna copy the patch notes, and the patch notes will be in my description, all right? So this is what I'm doing for y'all. Patch notes will be down there in the description unless they don't let me do it, but I'll put those down there. You can see the whole thing. Also a link to the 2K Discord where you can see all the patch notes. Let me know what y'all think down in the comment section, man. Do y'all feel like the defense was targeted here? Fairly or unfairly, it could have been targeted, but it was fairly. We needed some of these changes, bro. I'm not gonna lie to you, because people was out there spamming and playing defense. And so if we see a lot of locks just disappearing now, then we'll see what's going on. But in the morning, we will be checking it out. Come holler at your boy. We're gonna be streaming probably about an hour or so, maybe like 8:30 or so. And what we're gonna try to do is see if we can get some sub wars going, which that's just gonna be y'all against each other, PlayStation against Xbox, whatever. And I might need y'all to stream so I can get a proper view or whatever. We're gonna do like best of three series and stuff like that. And we're just gonna go like that and have some fun, man. Let me know what y'all think down in the comment section. I'm gonna holler at y'all next time. Till next time. It's your boy Jay Easy, aka Fresh from the Barbershop, BK the People's Champ. Godspeed.